Hi, my name is Mani Alikani. I am the Dean and Professor of CTOR Academy, and I'd like to welcome you to CTOR channel. The topic of today's discussion is moment. If you remember from the previous discussion when we were talking about the force and center of resistance, I mentioned that if the line of action of the force pass through the center of resistance, the object, or in our case the tooth, will move along the line of action without tilting. But what happens if the force does not pass through the center of resistance? Assume the force passed through the crown. Now there is a distance between the line of action of the force and the center of resistance. In this case, a tendency for rotation or tilting will appear in the system. This tendency for tilting or rotation is called moment. We should not make a mistake that felt moment means that we have additional energy inside the system. Just remember, the amount of the energy, whether the force, the line of action of the force pass through the center of resistance or does not pass through the center of resistance, stays the same. Only the distribution of the energy will be different, and therefore the distribution of the movement would be different. How we can measure the magnitude of the moment? Magnitude of the moment is equal to the magnitude of the force times the distance between the line of action of the force and the center of resistance. If you remember from your geometry class, the shortest distance between a point and the line is a perpendicular line that we can draw from that point to that line. Therefore, if you wanted to measure the distance between the center of resistance and the line of action, you just need to draw a perpendicular line from the center of resistance to line of action. Can you guess what would be the unit of this moment? As you can see, the unit of the moment should have the magnitude of the force, the unit of the force, that is centinewton or gram force, and the unit of the distance, that in this case would be millimeter. One of the characteristics of the moment, if you pay attention, is it seems is not like force. Force is multi-directional, but seems moment is not multi-directional. In every dimension that you look at the moments, they are either clockwise or counterclockwise. Doesn't matter which dimension you look at. And if you wondering how you can find if it is clockwise or counterclockwise, when you draw your force, just bend your force around the center of resistance. And that would be actually the direction of the moments that you have, clockwise or counterclockwise. Another interesting characteristic of the moment is that we can produce the moment with completely different type of forces, sometimes even opposite forces. Let's look at this example. If you look at your left side of your screen, you will see that a force that is applying to the apex of the tooth. And for now, don't ask how we can apply a force on the apex, so we'll talk about it later on. But the force that is applied on the apex of the tooth does not pass through the center of resistance, and therefore it produces a moment. The magnitude of this moment, as we discussed before, is equal to the magnitude of the force, in this case F1, times the distance that we represented as a D. And that produces a moment of the force, MF1. And in the right side, if you look at the screen, you will see another force, F2, assuming F2 is equal to F1, that as applies in the distance from the center of resistance, let's call it D, and that's also producing an additional moment, and that's called MF2. Because the F1 and F2 have the same magnitude, and because their distance are the same, the magnitude of the moment that they produce is the same. How about their direction? As I told you before, if you want to find the direction of the force, just bend the force around the center of resistance. In the left side, you can see if you bend the force around the center of resistance, the moments would be clockwise. In the right side, if you bend the force around the center of resistance, also the moment is clockwise. So we were able to produce the same moment applying completely different type of forces, opposite forces. And that's important clinically because many times when we wanted to produce a movement or tilting or rotation, we can take advantage of these principles and know that we don't have only one option. We can use different options to produce the same amount of moment. Another characteristic of the moment is that if you remember, we talk about that the moment is force times distance. So if you want to change the magnitude of the moment, either you can change the magnitude of the force, or you can change magnitude of the distance, and end result will be the same. So if in the left side, we apply 100 centinewton force to a tooth that is far away from the center of resistance, the line of action about 5 millimeter, the amount of the moment that you are producing is 500 centinewton millimeter. What happens if you reduce your force to 50 centinewton, but increase your distance to 10 millimeter? Again, your moment would be 500 centinewton millimeter. In both cases, if you draw the moment and just continue the force around the center of resistance, you will see you produced counterclockwise moment in both conditions. This is also very important clinically. In the conditions that we cannot apply high forces, but we need to have a good amount of moment, we just need to play with the distance. In that case, we can keep the force in minimum, and just by playing the distance, we can achieve the moments that we require for our patients. I just wanted to end this discussion with the examples that we had in previous discussion about the patients that have periodontal problem. Remember, in those patients, your distance between line of action of your force that applies to the crown and the center of resistance is large. Therefore, the magnitude of a moment that appear in your system is large. So you need to be very careful when treating these patients to not by applying a higher magnitude of forces to increase these moments even more than what you need. Thank you for watching another session of Mechanotherapy by CTOR channel. The next topic would be equivalent systems. So if you like to learn about equivalent system, please keep watching. Thank you.